This is the Stepping Razor. As we saw the other day on Thursday, I saw my own. They don't say, the way I'm not listening to the announcement, they don't forget to do that before they go for the announcement. So you know, we're up here at Trinity, we can't really all that talk about it, you know, because this is a serious thing, a serious thing. Brand new tune, Queen Africa. Oh, yeah, we're here in between the ad, the room, so I said, go. Now, we got to talk about the heat wave that take a whole heap of country, including Jamaica. This weekend, I was there in California, it was 102 degrees. We don't reach 100 degrees yet, but 102 degrees in California, which part we did there, 102 degrees. You know, when you're there in San Francisco, I mean, it's cold all the while, in the night all cold too, but it kind of weird that San Francisco is over the side there, and you drive a certain distance, and the place hot. But this heat thing is a weird thing if you're in a certain house and old people in there. So we just tell the people them say if you have old folks in your house, you have to make sure say them get enough liquid, because if your house not no air condition, especially in the garrison them where you have air condition, where you have to let again, because you have some people behind the zinc fence at some 52-inch TV. We do look at Garris already, I would say. We do some BMW park and zinc fence. And I hear the man them live. I mean, I say, the man them have a zinc fence, I don't know how to park the car, you know, and stuff. And the works are here, park the car, you know. So, I have to take back that. But say, you know, if you hear on the air condition, because some of them house there, people do a zinc fence, they say, you know, 52-inch TV, hot paint. Hot this, hot that, electric this, electric that. Anyway, what I say, we want you to take care of the elderly people them in a damn time when they eat a lick. Because trust me, you just walk, go there and come back and see the old people, the old ones gone. Because they eat not lovely. Because I tell you, say, I feel the eat all the outside now. And my yard, I use it for a peel tree on my yard. And that's why you must have more green space. Because the more concrete is the less you have oxygen a flow. And we need oxygen, carbon dioxide. You understand? We need oxygen for breathe. And if you don't have no woody pot trees around you and all, plants around you and them things, you're going to breathe clear where you're going with the concrete and the asphalt and the steel. You know? And when we talk about the heat now, we hear them about drought. And water not have this or water, they said, we shouldn't have ball for that. We shouldn't have ball for land around the water. We shouldn't have ball for water right now. When the two reservoirs in Kingston, how did I hear about 100 years ago them devote, you know? And you know, the population kept it dipping scrubble between St. Andrew and Port Moran and Central Kingston, you know? The amount of people in that area were never used to there. And at the same reservoir, them, the same dam, them, have the same amount of water, you know, the same thing. And every year come, it's the same thing. We shouldn't have ball, but we don't have no water to feed the plant, them. The thing is supposed to sit up long time. That's why everyone say, governments are frauds. Them fraudulent. They are fraudulent. You know, the other night I listen to me tell you, I watch my TV, I hear them talk about this parliament building supposed to go in the park, where they make the world around the Sokota, and the people there, they are trying to figure out, so we are going to be, and this is a liar man up on the TV and tell the people, see, they are going to be displaced and all them something. I lie them and tell them, you know, people of Almontown, people of Woodford Park and surrounding areas, don't follow what a brother there say on the TV, it's like Mattel. They cannot get architect for structure out and plan out how the building and how the place are going to set. And not include what the people that live already. So when I talk about this idea, it's like Mattel because they have competition and go on to say how they're going to set up the building and everything there. Don't follow these people. Them can go broke down on the building and then tell them, say, them want to give money for it and then they don't have nowhere to go. A whole heap of people going to get displaced. Mark my word. Don't trust these youth. Them following the same little lion people them within our own country over the years now. And them come with the same lion of them out and stand in front of the people. They want to tell the people them lie. There's no way. No way. In a Kingston gang, so Alman Town and surrounding the areas. Now we get licked down. How you say man you run, rush go down there to go buy people and quit because they don't know how the place are gonna set in the next 10 years. They so become prime real estate now, you know. Yeah, they'll become prime real estate. I can't take this people, that's why I say I can't even talk to people over here, they don't start. They're so convincing you, but deep within, cause if you take the people and the people they don't have no sense, you know. And not because you can't read, you don't have no sense, you know. Not because you can't eloquently talk, you don't have no sense, you know. And sometimes you will take the people and feed that. So they're going to set up the place and bypass the truck, bypass the people them when they're there, so. And they're going to move them, they're not going to demolish nothing, they're going to just refurbish the something them. So they're going to move the people them, and when them 6 over there, so they move them back in. Oh, you really believe that? Oh, you really believe so they're going to do that? They're going to do that? People of Alman Town, Prince Albert Street and all them, because street they always run up and down as youth. Go through Gosham Road, we used to live at Gosham Road, and we used to live down Banier Lane and Woodford Street, Woodford Park, right? Who do you really believe, say? They don't go that the plan of them have. No mean, say, we never get dislocated from our original life. We don't believe them on them. Lie them and tell. We tell them that. Say, lie them and tell. Don't follow what them say. See, on the demand is no right. The man in your right street. Them is I them go build up a better place than one of them right now. Put it in a place where you can live comfortable more than one I live there right now. Because they take with the land them. They go bulldoze this, move that. And the minister education building gonna tear down too. But you really check it. All of them building on the side is so gonna tear down. They need a good space. That's supposed to take into consideration. Anyway, click it.
Good afternoon, I am Hal Schoenberg with the Local International Head North. The Institute of Gender and Development Studies at the University of West Indies says the imbalance in the gender ratio in Poland places a greater risk for Jamaica to correct issues of human trafficking. Dr. Leith Don, sociologist and gender specialist from the Institute, says while Jamaica is doing well, the country will continue to be at risk if more women are not brought into the legislative process to address problems of human trafficking. Dr. Don noted that although the country's population consists of 51% females and 49% males, there continues to be very, very few women parliamentarians. She says that the disparity of females in Parliament needs adjusting. 38 students received scholarships today through a collaboration with the Jamaica Energy Partners and its affiliate company West Kingston Power Partners. Primary and secondary students who achieved academic excellence and reside in the West Kingston and St. Catherine areas were eligible for the scholarships. GSAT awardees will receive scholarships valuing $135,000, while tertiary students receive up to $1 million for the duration of their schooling. News overseas, an environmental audit committee has warned the number of heart-related fatalities in the UK will triple to 10,000 a year by the 2050s. The committee says that fatalities have already begun to increase, especially among older people who suffer increased fatalities from cardiac and respiratory disease during heat waves. It says homes and buildings, including hospitals and care homes built to keep the heat in, are at risk of overheating. Finally, U.S. President Donald Trump and Vice President Mike Pence have threatened to impose sanctions on its ally Turkey if the country does not release an American pastor being held on the House arrest. In a tweet, Donald Trump said the U.S. will impose large sanctions on Turkey for the non-attainment of Pastor Andrew Brunson, who he describes as a great Christian and paragon. According to CNN, Brunson, an evangelical pastor from North Carolina, was arrested in 2016 during a government crackdown on journalists, academics, and Christian minorities following an attempted coup. And those are the local and international headlines. Nigeria is at 5:45 for the IMF Newsroom. I'm Hal Schoenberg.
Thanks. Concrete asphalt. Come on, I'm from Florida 2 weeks ago. Never find up there, man. I say, could I come back here? You know, trying to go over there, man. It's like a different world, you understand? You know, man. I mean, until they say, me know a festival one time up there, a place near Dinosaur Rock, you know, and me supposed to go up on stage 11 o'clock in the night, you know. You see me go up on stage, it's so hot now, you know. And 1.5 hours me spend on stage, you know. See, by then I come up, 1.5 hour, what? Sunday, the war. The moon, 1.5 hour, me do on stage, and it's so hot. When you say, act like, oh, it's so hot, as somehow. And by the time you come up on stage, Rasta, the night, the place dark. Them places where you know, some of them had 4 or 5 months, they have no sunlight, you know.
Yeah, but in that place up there,
they
say 60 days,
they're
just
yeah.
One night, none of that.
And that made me know when people talk foolishness about the earth flat, you know. What about the earth flat? Mm-hmm. Because we know exactly why that happened, you know. Mm-hmm. We know exactly why that happened. They said they find water upon Mars. Yeah, they said they find water upon Mars. Yeah, so a year ago, I said, if you want to up there, so life farm supposed to up there. Yeah. I wonder if up there I come from. Maybe it's a Martian, I want it, you know. Yeah, man. I want to be a Martian, man. Yes. Anyway, we did not talk about this plan that them have. And then we realize now, you know, say, people here we talk about all slavery planning program, you know, concrete. And I said, well, they love dead man a long time thing. Them things they gone a long time, man. You know, say, years ago, like from your Rasta, we just outside Rasta, one of my first thing to stop me, my sugar. And I know, for no health reason, why I stop it, you know. I told me and say, you know, shall we come here, so, for them blood to continue to plant sugar cane for these Europeans. Loss for addiction, sugar and rum, and you know much millions of we dead, and so for that. So I say right now, me not really am that, you know. I can't part from enterprising. It really have a little stench in my brain then when I realize that chattel slavery inside of Jamaica was to preserve the appetite for European people to drink sugar and rum. So when we say no, slavery still exists, people are run up their mouth and I say, what are you talking about, mother? Them things are done long time and say, oh, fruitful. Well, listen to this now. We just get an article we ask which name we get out of the Observer. The headline says 7,000 Jamaicans are modern day slaves. 7,000 Jamaicans are modern day slaves. I'm going to check IRP staff, you know. That's right. I'm going to check IRP staff, you know. Count up and dig out the 7,000 and find out why. Companies, because sometimes it's too much to shackle from the foot, and when I don't shackle around the neck, we say slavery done. I don't know if they're slavery, them say emancipation, say from mental slavery, shackling our brains, and then the slave master now for dead to make you be a slave, you know. You just put certain things in place, and then you just follow. It's like you tie up a donkey for a post. For years you tie up for a post, you know. You see, when you pull it, it still stand up there, you know. Yes, it still stand up there. Even if you know time now, it's quite right now, enough about time, you know. Mm-hmm. Remember, you can pop your my yard, you know, Rasta. You see, there we go, you say, go to the bathroom. You must want to go to the bathroom, you know, we lock the door, you know. You say, there we go, you must lock the bathroom, you say, no, you won't go to the bathroom, you know. I tell you. So here we are, say, no. Globally, the sugarcane industry is identified as being involved in modern-day slavery. Globally, the sugarcane industry is identified as being involved in modern-day slavery. Now, if your government can hear this, you know, they have to plant ganja and rice on the land that they need to plant cane pan. They have to form and all them places. They have to do the sugar thing. They have to do the sugar thing, Rasta. Yeah, because you're the government over one side. Where the brother named Dr. What name again? The one where we talk to on the road there. The Minister of Health. Tufton. Who's not a health man? I find it out more last week, last time on the panel one. Why you have to mention this a tough time, you know? All right, sir. I see you, you know. Bastard hold you. Bastard hold him. All right, you know nothing, you know. The sugar move the land. The land there where the sugar plant, can, rice can plant for it, you know. And herbs. And if you want to plant ganja, plant hemp then. Because there's none of the things hemp can use for. Just like how hemp, cane, sugar cane trash can make baggers, bowl and everything there. Hemp can make more than what the sugar cane trash can make. There's thousands of different products where hemp can make. So hemp and rice is something we suggest. Me suggest I this thing so long, you know. It's like me just a little voice a crying at the wilderness, you know. Just like when me tell them, say, move them economical connection from the north and go to the south. Go to Africa. Because the African market is still almost like a virgin market. And white people know that. But see, the Prime Minister gone down there, you know. Forgot the entire, for listening for the BRICS people, them. BRICS, B-R-I-C-S, is a combination of Brazil,
India.
Russia, India, China, and South Africa. Mm-hmm. And we see the South African, them, move them economical wealth and strength away from America. And they move closer to China now. So most of the people on the other side, they want to see over the side, you know, and say, why, over the upper north, you know, now work for you again, you know. Now work for you again. So, what more advertisement again? This is some special fat dries up next. I bet you when we did done, you know what I'm going to say. Okay, eh? I see what you're talking about. Asphalt. Mm. Me, I got to check IFM workers, them, you know. You hear what I say? All right. Young man, that's up. Me bet the man say, young guy, get up here. I'll be making comment. All right, kick it. Okay, so we're going to talk about this slavery thing here. And this report where them have a circulate. Slavery is in effect. African people. Listen to what we are saying now, because sometimes we are talking, you know, fish are mad, we are getting mad, and we are living in the past. Slavery is in effect. And the first part of the article say, globally, the sugarcane industry is identifying as being involved in modern-day slavery. And apart from you have slavery in the modern-day slavery in the sugar industry, you also have a place point now where Jamaican people are young too much sugar, so it's a double liquid get. Slavery in the sugar industry and diabetes by eating the sugar when slave them. When slave them, I remember this thing, we send where the sugar got fired, you know, and then beat it out and send it back. The granulated sugar, just like we send it back tight over there, and then make it out in aluminum and send it back over here, so you know, they charge it, not only for me, you know, we sell them for. But also for them to produce it back to alumina. You know see? So, as Jamaica begins to celebrate Emancipation Day and I will write that article, like a sweet regional sister in this. As Jamaica prepares to celebrate Emancipation Day on August 1st, there are some 7,000 people living in modern-day slavery on the island according to the Global Slavery Index published on Thursday. You know, last night we play a documentary about modern-day slavery around the world. Yeah, although slavery and the four-year apprenticeship period officially ended 180 years ago, 2.57 people out of every 1,000 living in Jamaica are estimated to be living as slaves, the report said. Now, for those of you who define slavery as chattel, you have other kind of slavery as not chattel. Globally, the report estimates that some 40.3 million people are living in modern-day slavery, with 71% of these females. 71% of females, you know. So you must not talk about that, like sex slave and all them things there. Yeah, and pedophile, the Italian, them big pan the pedophile thing, you know. I tell you that, you know. And then, you see, you see the people them that take boat and I go cross from each in Europe there. And anything them get to do, them do it, you know. I see show these white people, you know. Say they will do anything. Catch them and do anything. You see now Jamaica, it's still that you hear some people that say, why them I go and fire me because them get a job. Especially the woman, you know. They don't want to see a Jamaica because things too hard. So they look at the paper and say, just like how you look on that now, when the Indian them offer this and this and that. Them man there, you have to watch them people, they tell the astrological people, they tell you say, if your man left you, if you want visa, if you want this and that, just come check them, let them get your aisle room, either get visa, either check the you understand? Either check the police, make him look here, the ticket and all that stuff there. Well, 40.3 million people are living modern day slavery, with 71% of these females and 29% males. Some 24.9 million of the total are believed to be in forced labor, with another 15.4 million in forced marriages. The forced marriages are more like in India. The kind of forced marriage thing there, but the daughter them, a woman for the daughter them will leave you, so. Because them here say, they will get job in America, especially America. Them gone at this place and gone at that place. Because they reach over there, it appear like it's a job they might do, and it end up saying them can't do certain things, and they want to stay there. And just because of circumstance, most of the time it's circumstance, because you have some of them go over there, if you go turn prostitute, you know, because the money is bigger over there, so. Because too many people know them over there, so they want to stop in a corner where nobody will know them, you know. And they say, I'm part of them, they say, what more time will you wait? But wait, you know, you see my watch when I come from, come from continent at night time. Them not say that about me, you know, but you know, like how you know, who know them regular, you know what I mean? Yeah. Alright, so we could go again. With some 24 million of the total are believed to be in forced labor, with another 15.4 million in forced marriages. With the little known forced marriages in Jamaica, the country has a prevalence index rank of 112 out of 167 in Latin and the world countries for its level of slavery. You know, Russia big with slavery, you know. Yeah, Russia and China. Russia, China, India, them countries, they big with slavery. That put it well behind 80. See, they must have put it. See, they have to go behind 80. At least we're behind somebody in the Caribbean. The first country to overturn slavery some 215 years ago, which is 80. The first country to overturn slavery 200 years was 80. According to report, 80 has some 55,000 people living as slaves out of the population of 10.7 million. Given it a rating of 62 out of 167, the rate of slavery is 5.55 people per 1,000. The second highest in the Americas, just behind Venezuela at 161 with a rate of 5.58% per 1,000. In fact, Jamaica has a smaller proportion of modern slaves than any of the other Caribbean countries listed. All right, I could clap your hand for that. We have less slaves than Barbados. And we have less slaves than Trinidad, Guyana, Dominican Republic, Cuba, Suriname. All right. You see, when I'm telling you, 7,000 slaves in Jamaica. I want to double that, you know. Yeah, man, you have some people that come from the radar, you know, we have work hard, you know. And you get no pay, you know. Man, I tell you, come back the next week. Man, say, work hard, you know. And sometimes, because you don't get no bonus, you know. And you don't get no raise of pay to the level where you can't go say, boy, right now. You understand? You have companies in the States, you know. Yeah, man, big corporate countries, companies, man. When time comes, you're going to get raised up here, man. Let me tell you, I talk of foolishness like, well, see, we just buy some bone, you know. We buy the bone, man. The bone is kind of expensive, you know. And then you end up, I get less than what I value. That is the thing, you know. And you see, you don't have money. You can't talk out because you're afraid if you lose. They make a times for your get. Now because they want to pay your slave, you know. You know what a slave, you know, it's when you can't leave where you're there. You fit fine because of the time you get. You get, you are submitted. You are submission. From which part you get to the point where, but if you think, and if you try one of them people and you don't say, you don't have nowhere to go. Because, like a lot of you just let school run out them something there. And then the man look a prostitution on the side, you know. And you don't know, I talk about the man, you know. Mm-hmm. You have one prostitute, you know, more for them than New Kingston, you know. Mm-hmm. I sell themselves, you know. And then you have some other people, you know, a big boy, them, you drive them out to these bands. Take the youth, them. And say, why you don't have that for the time? Some people up a fine there. And they'll just sell you. You know, think that's sell them, I tell you, you know. Because when they do it, them guys cannot sell them, I tell you, you know. They must sell you to foreign. It's an attention, you know, to your team, you know, in a Jamaica, you know. Things better there. So you see these people, you know, with them slavery thing, you know. The man will say, you really don't have nowhere to go. So they must unappear you. And you say, you shout. You say, you're gone. You know, see it. And you have house to pay for, where you have mortgage. If you don't have mortgage, you have rent. You have picked the level, you got school. You, if you're a woman, you have a man to help out. Because I don't know how to help out them woman. If you understand? Slavery is not just shackle. Slavery is not just things on your foot. It's a serious thing. There's a slavery also exists across Europe. With the worst offender being Turkmenistan. With a rate of 11.2 followed by Belarus. And where them countries are coming from? Macedonia, which is Greece, part of Greece. A member of the European Union was fourth highest in Europe with a rate of 7.91 per 1,000. Ranking 27th. In the survey, alright, because this is serious thing, you know, serious thing. That's why we hear Jamaican people are bad out for them, for money, forget with them value. And people are saying, you can't pay them at this time, at this time, at this time, and you get vexed. You see, because when you look at the overall place where you work, you realize that something right. Because all you can't get no more money, yet still. When you look, you see, one heap of garbage spin all over the place. You understand? And one heap of door. When you open one door, you try to go out by the bars there. Which door you go through, you understand? So, we need to understand that slavery is not just chained by your foot. As a matter of fact, it's worse when you're chained by your foot. Because you feel complacent about the slavery where you find yourself in. Because not upon the TV they know slavery, you know. Yeah, because when some Indian can come here, so, and sell you, Hila get visa. And when you do, get sell Hila get visa long time, you know. But we want just one club man again. Because you're too shabby. They want to have one gold, this and silver, this and thing, and blink all your eye. When you go check them, because they were come from India with all them bling, 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 bling. And you know, I see that as bling, bling. And when you come from China, you see it as bling, bling. But you have bling, bling in India too. And then people, they have them people lying up, you know, oh, we can get some job for you in Khartoum. And we can get some job for you in Delhi. And then we're there. Yes, Delhi. May I tell you, it's a serious, serious thing. You find yourself in a terrible situation. Slavery is in effect. Look on the good. Slavery is in effect. Okay, click it. We're there with you in between the advertisement there. We just talk about modern day slavery and just because people don't see them chain around their foot. They feel them going to slavery. Sometimes you are trapped in a workspace and you can't come out because you have certain things to do and you little with them a girl can't make them uncle. And then you realize that right now you're trapped in it so much that you are forced to stay here. Maybe not by the people in power, but the people in power you know, say this is where you're at now, so you are forced to stay because you don't have an alternative. That is slavery. When a man get trapped in a something where he don't want to continue to do and can't leave because of the circumstances you find himself in a thing, that is slavery. And if 7,000 people, them say 7,000 slaves in Jamaica, modern day slaves, you're going to double that. You're going to double that. Because you have people don't know to them is slave. Because they must not shackle. This is the stepping razor. The art of war. You know that IRFM tribute coming up on the 19th of next month, which is a Sunday, and it is always a wonderful thing to be old, to be just here celebrating Marcus Garvey and all the different sites and so on here. So we have one of the participants who's coming all the way. I don't know if she's in Haiti, but she's a person from Haiti. We want to say Haiti, because the Haiti thing touch it. We want to talk to the sister here. Can see she has a line here. Good afternoon. Good afternoon. Alright.
I'm too harsh, Tom, but don't you better? You have less than 1 minute.
Okay. Right. Less than 1 minute. Hello? It looked like our
food. Yes.
Hi, good afternoon.
Hello?
Yes, I am here now. You are hearing me?
Good afternoon.
Yeah, this is Mota Baruka. Okay, she's not here properly.
Yes.
Are you hearing me? We have a phone connection, you know.
Hello?
Yes, I am hearing you. Are you hearing me?
Yes, sir.
All right, good. This is Miss Bello.
Yes, I'm Baina Bello.
Baina Bello, okay. And you are from Haiti?
That's correct. Speaking to you from Haiti.
All right, we want to say it will be wonderful to have you here. I have seen some of... Wow, what a terrible thing that. Oh, yeah. This lady that we're going to speak to is a teacher, writer, volunteer, and Liberia, Nigeria, and Togo. She visited all the West African countries and several others on the continent. She's fluent in Asian Creole, French, English, Arabic, and Hausa, and currently working as professor at the State University of Haiti. She earned her first administrative degree in New York State University, then to gain a BS in education and MS in linguistics. Our professional teaching career began in 1968-69 in the USA while teaching Arabic and Muhammad University of Islam. We don't want to introduce her with a long introduction here, and then we can't get her on the phone. So you're going to do. Yes, stepping razor. So I think we have the professor below on the line again. Good afternoon.
Good afternoon, sir.
Can you hear me good now?
Yes, it sounds better.
Okay. All right. We know that you are coming for the Marcus Garvey celebration. How much have you been to Jamaica already?
Oh, yes. I've been to Jamaica several times.
Oh, yes?
And, one of the times was, in February, Brother Bethel Lopez used to do an activity there.
Okay.
The Kabamba.
All right. So, what is the main subject that we're supposed to expect? What is your subject? What you want to talk about?
Free our minds. We have to free our minds if we want to be free.
Mm-hmm.
We cannot continue to recite other people's lessons. Take orders from others as to what to do in our country.
Okay.
And believe that we are free.
All right. You know that?
So.
Before you came on the air, we were talking about modern day slavery. And that they are saying that 7,000 Jamaicans are under modern day slavery. And they mentioned Haiti in it. And can you give us a little overview of what is happening in Haiti as it relates to the scourge here called modern day slavery? And who is the perpetrators of this modern day slavery in Haiti?
That's correct. We have to face up. If we want to change anything, that's the other thing. We cannot tell lies to ourselves. We have to speak the truth, no matter how hard this truth. And one of the hard truths is, freedom is a daily battle. And yes, we did wonderful things in 1803. And yes, it was fabulous to declare independence on January 1st, 1804. Then what have we done in the fighting to establish and maintain our freedom? So if you do not fight to maintain what you've got, then somebody else is always ready to snatch it away from you.
Yeah. What is the farms? What is the farms in Haiti that's there? Because we don't have, like, trafficking. Human trafficking is a major scourge as it relates to human trafficking. What is the farm that modern slavery take in Haiti?
To me, that's where the concentration has to be. Concentration has to be, how do we get out of the mental structure where we do not know who we are? We do not know how to liberate ourselves. They will always, there's people their discourse when they want us to talk about, well, what form of slavery do you have over here and what form of slavery do we have over there? But what we need to talk about, how do we free ourselves? How do a people take charge? Individuals take charge of themselves so they can know themselves and free themselves. And once the people reach a level of freedom, then they force those who pretend to be leaders or elite to behave a certain way. You see, one of the big lessons in our history in Haiti, Despin has a letter where he wrote and said, I'm trying to figure out how does one become the leader of a people who have already decided they want to be free. So it's not the leader that says you need to be free. The leader has to become aware at some point that the people want to be free. And in his thinking, he says, I realize that in order to be free, to be the leader of the people who want to be free, I must become free instantaneously. How does one become free? To become free, you must cut off your head. And you must detach from all possessions. You must cut off your head and detach from possession. What does that mean? He's going to go on in this letter to say, come into the house I was building for the past 10 years. Finally finished. My wife will never have a chance to sleep in it because I just set fire to it. His own house. So obviously, we need to understand, cut off your head means change your mentality. And you must get rid of, you must be detached. It doesn't mean that you don't need anything, but you must not be attached to the things that are in your life. Because you have to understand that the highest of all possessions is freedom. The greatest of all value is freedom. And unless we become we get back to the mental structure where we want to be free by any means necessary, at all costs, beyond everything, we want to be free. If we don't want to be free, then we will be somebody's slave.
Well, I would just mention,
because your energy can always be used.
Yeah.
Excuse me?
Yeah, no, I was just mentioning, you said that We all want to be free, and freedom comes through the liberation of your mental capacity to understand that. First, you have to know that slavery exists, and then say you're going to go come out of that slavery by any means necessary.
Exactly.
All right, the any means necessary. Exactly. The any means necessary sometimes can pose a problem. I mean, we could say that years ago, we say any means necessary by the ballot or the bullet, by the Bible or the gun, any which way freedom must come. Now, there is a level of the capacity to understand any means necessary is thwarted by modern technology and globalization. Globalization, modern technology, sometimes get in the way of that any means necessary philosophy. Or you see that?
No. Actually, if we understand that everything begins with each one of us, each is responsible, first of all, for his own freedom. If I am not free, I cannot help you. I must be a free woman to be able to help someone else. Therefore, I must have the kind of mental, I must establish in myself, the kind of mental structure that will make me a free woman. A woman who is able to make a difference. For example, what you eat, most of us do not choose. We go according to what publicity is going on around us. So if they say you should drink this, even if it's pure poison, we buy it. But we're not free people. They are already programming that we eat and drink things that will make us sick, and that will guarantee that we go to the doctor, make them rich, the hospital, the pharmacy, make them rich, and they don't even have a worry about our health. They just want to diminish the pain. So they will always give us medicine that will not cure the problem, but will make us come back every 2 weeks, every 3 weeks, every 2 months to pay more money and buy more medicine. Things like sugar problem, things like hypertension and whatnot, these are easily curable by with natural medicine. But the things that you go to the doctor and they prescribe to you and you have to buy will just keep you enslaved to that disease. You will, for the rest of your life, be giving yourself insulin shots that will change nothing. So, the structure, if we have a serious conversation with ourselves, we have to understand we've gone to a school created by the ones who created the slavery system. So how could they make a school that will teach you how to be free? How could they create a medical system that will keep you free from illnesses when everything about them is making money by any means necessary in every situation?
Yeah.
So we have to look for our freedom in the choices that we make for what we eat.
Yes.
We have to look for freedom in the way we deal with sicknesses. We have to look for freedom as we go to school and learn from their books, their thoughts, their philosophy. We have to look for other books that will teach us our way or the ways of our ancestors. If we can only decide when we're talking, Dr. So-and-so's father was a slave dealer. But when you think about that, we are quoting and supporting people who have no aspiration but to take us, make us, and maintain us.
Yes, 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 yes. Well,
we go to churches where everybody, every saint, every God, every angel, nobody looks like you and I.
Yes. That is not the biggest problem. That is one of the biggest part of the problems.
That is the root of the problem.
Yes.
Because once they can convince you that the divine does not look like you, then they've already won.
Yeah.
Because all the power of humans comes from its divine perception.
Yes. Your perception is not you, therefore. It's not your perception.
Exactly.
Yes. Okay, so look here now. We have a limited time. I know you could go on and I could listen to you, but we're going to wait until you are here. And we hope to meet you. I hope to meet you. You know. And
it would be a pleasure and an honor.
Eh?
It would be a pleasure and an honor to meet you.
Yeah, ma'am. So I'm looking forward to it. And we give thanks for the small time, man. You said a lot in the small time, and we give thanks for that. Give thanks.
That's fine. We give thanks.
Thanks.
And may you be blessed. Ancestral blessings to all of you at the radio station and all of you in Jamaica. Be blessed. Know yourself and discover your true power.
Give thanks. Give thanks. Yes. Comfortable sister, into what you're saying. As you can hear her, how comfortable she is in what you're saying. But you know, Bella, IT, historian, teacher, writer, humanitarian, and she will be in Jamaica here for a Marcus Garvey tribute on the 19th of August. That is 4 days after Marcus Garvey's birthday, right here on the grounds. In a car park or the car post, I don't know what time, what, which part, when I was a car post, I mean, I was a car park. But it's right here on the grounds of IFM, the only radio station that put out that effort for years now to celebrate one of the greatest philosophers of the 20th century, 21st century too. And that is not saying it as a black man saying what about linking him with all of these big philosophers. He's recognized as one of the greatest philosophers of our time. Marcus Mosiah Garvey, born in St. Anya, IRFM born in St. Anya, and Tualem Kalek. Where were they? Yes, Stephen Razor, the art of war.
Yeah, good evening, Mr. Mota.
Good evening, sir, man.
You don't know that, bro. I give thanks.
You know, bad.
Over there, I'm talking to my man. It's a long time, I'm not seeing you. I'm not passing you. What can you do now here again? I'm not seeing you at all.
So, you know, sir, I'm going to go to the house. I'm going to go
to
the house. I'm going to go to the house. I'm going to go to the house. What do you mean? Which part you stand up? Tell me where you stand up.
Well, you don't know what I work, I'm working about my hours, book up in that turn. Last time, I book up over, I think, so I don't
know. You know, that's why you still book me up.
That's why I go still, but you know what I call it, I...
No, hold on there. Which part me used to pass you? Tell me.
Alright, you see which part, Big Ben there?
Big, the clock?
Yeah.
Yes.
Right, that's
what
I always
demand. You used to drive past.
You're not even knowing me again, you know?
Chua, where is it, Chua?
Chua, bro, you know?
Oh, you look like
Chua. No, no, no.
Yeah. I Chua.
I just do.
All right, well, you see me yell me up, yeah?
Yeah, man.
I mean, I remember who.
All right.
Tell me, sir, you are here to look at the clock.
Yeah, man.
All right, sir. So, hello.
Yeah, you know, I'm not so good in my day, you know?
What happened now?
From a big man level, you know what I say? My brother dropped out Friday the 13th.
Oh, last, the bridge you don't hear about, but they are waiting for some doctor business and them never come.
Yeah, man. Same thing.
Yeah.
And you know, so I'm going to try to voice my opinion and for higher authorities step in and do something about it, but...
Nobody has said nothing to you.
No, so nobody has said nothing to me, man. Ignore me.
So you get a lawyer?
Yeah, man, we have a lawyer, man, and we tell him to deal with everything, you know? But we still have to make a real world, man, so you can help you out.
Go on, let me hear what I go on.
I want to say Friday the 13th, we better develop decompression sickness due to the fact that he went.
Hey, tell your brother to tap him nice behind you.
Yeah, man, me just tell him.
What do you tell him? It's a signal you give.
Don't talk to him, man.
Signal you give,
alright. Yeah. So, you know what I say? In start, in cry, for pain, you know what I say? I'm going to feel stress. You know, he not breathe properly.
Yeah.
So, we can't want him pain, but I'm asthmatic, you understand?
Yeah.
So, we rush him to a nearby doctor office, right? On Exchange Road. Mm. And we use the ambulance to rush him to the St. Anne's Bear Hospital. Upon reaching the hospital, he was brought into the emergency area where they offered some assistance to him. Right, being there, that was about 12:21, somewhere about that, in the day. And then we say, we better be there, and we speak to the people, to cut long story short, we speak to the people, down by Discovery Bay, right, because you know, I have compression sickness, due to the fact that you went diving, you went too deep, and due to the...
lungs.
Yeah,
ruptured.
Decompression sickness, you know, so air can get under the skin or it can go in the bloodstream. Air can just go anywhere in the body because of the nitrogen.
Mm.
You get your message? So,
yeah, man,
you know, yes, Mr. Morton, I hear
you. No, man, listen to what you say. Me agree with what you say.
Yeah, man, so he was at the hospital and the doctors, did what they could at the time. And you know, so we were told that he has to go to Discovery Bay. Mm-hmm. So they're going to put him in the decompression chamber, where they're going to put him back under some level of pressure, like he was deep, like he was diving.
Yeah.
That we know the air will be released from his body because they're going to put him back under pressure slowly release the pressure from him.
Like him under water still?
No. It is a machine where when
you come like him on the water and release.
Yes.
Yeah.
That is the step. But you know, a doctor has to do that because they have to be precise with them things.
Yeah, yeah.
So we were at the hospital and we were told the things, the necessary things that we need to proceed to Discovery Bay. And we were told by the persons in Discovery Bay that it's $130,000 to sort it out. Kirby Smallan, who is now dead.
And he was in the
emergency area, right?
Mm.
So he said, all right, we're going to go for the $130,000 carry come.
Yeah.
That is like full away from the hospital, out by Clarksville. And we don't have sentence to be hospital.
Yeah.
Right? So by we leave from the emergency and go to Clarksville and reach back within 10 minutes, we can't find our brother.
Yeah.
When we do search and find him, he was removed and placed, right, on a ward, a new medical ward. So I said, why don't you move him from emergency and put him down here, sir?
Mm-hmm.
Right? They said, I'm stabilizing.
Okay.
So then can move him.
Yeah.
So we said, all right, the money is here, right?
Yeah.
So we need an ambulance. We can go at Discovery Bay. Because we know the sickness. We have, you know, we know
the president of the ambulance.
We deal with it from early.
Yeah.
Then, so they have the ambulance.
You tell my man.
Two ambulance park.
Yeah.
Then I back in my station, you know.
Yeah.
With the ambulance station from the hospital. Yeah. Two ambulance park. Then, you know, they have no ambulance. So, alright. A hospital and we can run around them. So, we get one ambulance.
Yeah.
Yeah, man. We get one ambulance and we bring it to the hospital.
Where you get the ambulance from?
From the same doctor's office that was Yeah, understand?
Yeah.
So Monday did it, ambulance did it.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
We still can't get your brother. Alright, so it'll get late now, it'll get in the night, you know. Right, and when I see nothing happen, and my brother did it, I ball failed. You understand? In my ball failed, and I said, can't breathe.
So when you not tell him, I tell him my ball failed. When you not tell him, I do when I'm saying my ball failed.
Them not do nothing. Them not do nothing, you know. I'll tell you, alright, so after that now, we decide, so, but it can get too late, so we really need him to go down with the case. And the doctors already interviewed him from down by the lab. And that is from Discovery Bay, the Marine Lab, they interviewed Mr. Smallan already. Mm-hmm. That means to say, he was okay to leave because the doctors spoke with him on the phone. We still can't get him. So we did the whole process on my program, alright, and nothing not happening. Until him start get restless again, because you know the decompression sickness, it can rise up at any time. And it's not a sickness when you stabilize the person, right? Based on my studies of it, right? When you stabilize the person, the symptoms can just spurt out at any time. You don't have no signal to
like blood pressure.
Right. You know? Like a man, you just crash. Something will happen sudden. So when I say to the doctor, then we say, what happened? Because we there too long, we there for after 12 in the day. And now I saw 6 o'clock, 6:30. Nothing still not happening where I wait. Right? Alright. So they are saying that there's a doctor who have to sign him out. Where is the doctor? We can't find no doctor.
Where is the doctor? Oh, you mean sign him out to say no, they're not responsible for after I leave.
Remember, so a doctor has to sign a piece of paper.
Yeah.
Then if a doctor has to sign a piece of paper for releasing, so he can go to the ambulance to go and discover the DNA.
Okay.
You understand?
Yeah.
So we can't get the person unless a doctor do that.
Yeah, and right? Doctor no did it.
Alright. So while the, we don't go to no doctor no did it, no?
Yeah.
But no attempt to leave.
Come and hear that story 500 times already in my life.
Yeah. So while we are doing now, I said to them, hey, we brother, nah breed him. I said, nah breed. Right, you want him pump. So them say, we can't use the pump. So no, we can't carry nothing from outside.
But they say, you can't use the pump?
Right. Then I said, but a doctor's rule that still. I asked the doctor, you can't carry your medication from outside.
Like past medication.
Because he's already a patient in the hospital.
Yeah. You're responsible.
So I tell them, so I have asthma. Okay. So now with the decompression sickness I go on in now, you have asthma.
Yeah.
So they need to do something about it because I'm saying, can't breathe. Yeah. My ball is for health and I say, can't breathe. And I say, nurse, we're not going to make the dead and still not do nothing. How long do I tell him, sir?
Yeah.
If you relax.
And I pick them for you. Yeah.
You can't relax, you know, Mr. Muta, with decompression sickness, you know, because it causes fatigue, right? Yeah, it causes your joints, them to make your... fidget, you make you do all these different things, you're uncomfortable.
Yeah.
Right? When I study that thing, you are supposed to be elevated in your body.
Alright, now you have to tell me exactly what's going on, because we're not going to spend all the time. So
yeah, man, so that you're elevated in your bed, you have him lie down.
Yes.
Right? So when I say to the people, they say, hey, doctors might be intelligent, but you have something on your Google, so you go to your phone and Google tell you everything, and I say, but everything is going wrong in yourself.
Yeah.
So why nobody not do anything? Alright, time I run out now, you know, right? The lady from the ambulance now, come and I said, boy, she there too long now, where I go and when I get him to carry him, go and discover it, because everybody are with. So, we deal with that and the lady will drive the ambulance, cut story short, the lady will drive the ambulance, go check on him now, I said she can't wait no longer, when she go to the lady, find out, say, he will do well. So the lady bawled out and said, oh, no, she said, man, I did. and she grabbed the effect of school falling off of the nurse's neck. Mm. I run go check him and I said, no, sister, the man are weak. The man are dead. You understand?
Mm.
And she, after I do, well, she care everything for the man while the nurse and everybody where they did it on their phone.
Yeah.
And I take no talk for it. And the person who drive the ambulance, that is illegal now, because if somebody mentions he's going to hospital, go drive to the street now, farmer.
So why should I not know what I'm to him? He's dead. He's dead.
Yeah, so why should I do that? He's dead. Then come and get him back.
So when the nurse come, did I look upon him and say no? When the man say, about, when the man say this or no?
Watch this now, he's dead. Mother, father, nobody couldn't see him. Right, they must sign a piece of paper, say the man dead. And nobody not get a chance to see him. Then put security guard in place. Stop it for a scene. So we are saying to somebody we know see. When you take a stat and we check a piece of paper, where doctor write a female upon the table, paper and curb your man. You understand?
You're serious?
So then, yeah man. Curb is a male and they have, if you say. Curb is a well-known man, you know. Right?
Yeah.
Because
he's
a racer.
When did it happen? You don't have to inside that, so when it happened last week?
Yeah. Alright, watch this. We have the doctor in final, so we rest him about the situation. So then we call a meeting. Right?
Yeah, but you know, Bridget, it cannot take a little long time, I don't know. What do you know? What do you know? What do you know?
Well, you know, we are carried to the court. We have one more demonstration next week, Saturday.
Alright.
You understand? Because nobody now come forward. Somebody to come forward, come talk to. We need somebody to help.
I don't mean to say. Alright, my virgin, what's the name of my virgin? His name is a tough time. You know about your brother, brother, eh?
Yes, man.
Alright, you know, come see me and my virgin, you know. So, may I go make somebody call him from down here, if you hear about it, and if you want to hear about it, you're going to try to figure out if you want to hear about it. And
yeah.
Make you see where I'm from, this so. But you just go and do what you do. Go and do what you do, but you know, them way they call, when we talk to these people, we have to make the, find out if they hear about it.
Yeah, man, I understand, man.
All right, so, go and do what you do, and we tell you, if we get the minister, if we get the minister, we're going to figure out somewhere, we're going to make sure Mara figure out something else, all right?
Yeah, man, give thanks, man, I look forward to your assistance.
Yeah, look here, you know how well people think about everything, you should not turn up on the clock, man.
No,
you're going to
send me
better
for now, eh?
Yeah.
Sometimes you have to observe something.
Oh,
you
observe.
Yeah, man.
Oh, that's why you know
what I'm doing. I'm not doing nothing like that, but sometimes you're going. But because a man might see me and you know wear shoes and you know dress up certain way, that I mean, this is my intelligence, you know, so I'm with them. Just now,
I'm not telling that. I'm not telling you. Now I'm telling you that story. I want to remind that over between 4 and 5 is brought to you by Guinness, made of more.
Purity, 100% whole wheat bread, is the only bread in Jamaica that is internationally certified by the Whole Grains Council to have 100% whole grains. The time by Purity is...
Yeah, the time is 16 minutes past 4 o'clock. I'm going to remind you again that the over between 4 and 5 is brought to you by Guinness, made of more. How many people dead already?
The almost are officially dead now.
Okay, so not ready.
The people are after they put them stone in the road, but after they make them take time for the road, I pay them for the treatment for white.
Pay them all.
Yeah, I think I forgot to come back to come clear out the situation better. So my car can probably won't get the magic show for the face or the kind of voice.
What are the calls for the area?
The calls, Crystal Lee.
So you're not going to try it? Okay, if you call upon her then, call upon her too.
No,
I'm Bobby Montague, your car, so call it for them.
Yeah, Bobby Montague and Crystal Lee. I'm going
to see the division. Okay, all right. Tell me exactly how it's by your talk.
Last command.
Okay.
That's coming up in Charleston.
Charleston. Yes.
From 3 years to from country club and school over the situation with that. But then take on Buddhism and great authority and Mars is up here right there, my brother.
And let me can see the long.
Yeah man, I mean, couple weeks well now that it then fix on the part of materials. But then in a bit, yeah, with the water people living in Alaska, man, it's on a pure mouth of that, brother.
But you know, when you really start falling up, you monkey monkey, I was in auto.
You understand, pay monkey monkey.
Terrible.
Yeah, man, so I'm calling pandemics of those things, so they can go to play.
All right, so give thanks, yeah?
Yeah, bless him.
Yes. And as a matter of fact, you know, I look at things through the junction, you know, they might dig off the water, well, apartheid, the side of the hill there. So they might block it off at a certain hours, and where people are ball, say, the time they might block it off, I will tell them do it in the night. Well, I'm doing it in the hours, them use the people have to move through there, so. Oh, them people do them thing, you know, them do it opposite, they not consult people to find out this and that. But common sense, you just show them certain things. Common sense, simple show them things that you can't lick the road. Because you have a heap of light where you can't turn on in a road no man. And modern technology as of now. You can fix road 12 o'clock at night. 2 o'clock in the morning. But let me tell you how I'm pay the workers them overnight, overpay, and turn them in a modern day slave. But really and truly, the road is a major road that it link the north with the south. A Kingston to send me around Portland there. And you know, I see serious, you know, I drive back through the day, I drive through the day, I come from Florida. I drive back through the till it fix, you know. No serious thing. So, you know, they need for rethink the hours. I think they need for rethink the hours when they have a lock off the road. And you know, some of them talking at the interest of a whole heap of driver will go through this, so. Say, if them could have rethink the hours when they have a lock off the road, because trust me, there's a lock off, you know, I'm not trying to root for going on, it's just lock off, you understand? So, yes, I hope them are listening. At least them are listening, we know them are listening. It's very important, you know, I want to tell you about the celebration of life for Mama Ayata, who had dealt with his sister in the past way. Mama Ayata, during the celebration of her life, had born all OSS, July the 29th, 4 p.m. Dress code royal. They said, don't wear black. No black. So Mama Ayata, she leave us. We will be celebrating her life. I will be there. Yes. Mama Ayata, born all OSS. July the 29th at 4 p.m. Yes, yes.
Yes, Bota.
Blessed man.
Blessed love, my brother.
I did.
I have something to share with you, you know.
All right.
What's happened to me in the bank system, you know?
The banking system?
Yes, man, as I asked the man.
Okay.
I never know about a banking system now, rat tonight, you know.
No, I won't.
Understand. Rat.
You never know said you have rat?
Yeah, 4 foot rat.
Oh.
In the banking system, and they need to come out tight.
Where you call 4 foot rat?
I'm not sure something, I don't know.
No, where you call 4 foot rat?
Human being at 4 foot rat.
2 foot them have, man.
Huh?
Human being have 2 foot.
Yeah, but them have 4 in turn rat.
Okay, alright, sir.
You never know that.
No, I'm never see one yet, but if you say so, I don't know.
Yes, my brother. Right now, my brother, I have a little money in the Scotia Bank I watch there. And then my brother then said, boy, my bank book, null.
Your bank book what?
My bank book, null.
It's empty.
it's empty. We go back and I said to the young man, sir, I know some bank book empty, but I put some money in it. And the brother friend and my friend took the money in it, but after 12 years, the money in the bank account, and my brother the bank account, empty CMA, but
12 years you have it in there?
12 years,
but you never put no more money in there?
We don't put no more money in it, but
alright, I can't ask how much money is in there?
Well, it's over us trying to, we have to tell you that, see in person and tell you that.
Nobody know who I talk to, my man.
Yes, man.
Everybody know who you talk to.
Yes, man.
But if you don't have it again, you can't.
It's, alright, let me explain to you. It's 354-35,000. Almost
35,000
US.
Oh, you see, alright, so you have to tell me, okay, in that 12 years, then thief that.
That we get that from independent, 2000.
So can go first, so tell me something, what you do now? Where you go to the bank, what them say?
Them say, boy, I'm not an account today, no, my brother.
The account, diamond, what them do? Tell me what they say, so you're not an account there?
Yeah, them say, my account normal. That means I'm not an account today.
So you don't have nothing for sure to say about account there?
Then I have the bank account, my brother. I'm on the last right tonight.
You have the book?
I have the book, my brother.
And the book have the money printing there?
Yeah, the book have the money printing tonight. The last money print tonight. Can we meet when I said that to the young man said, me, sir, he said to me, sir, I'm not a Rasta man, this amount of money can't hold another book.
Because it didn't fall up already?
The book is empty, and the amount of money we're not, no, instead of the amount of money
we're not. So, touch each and another them and push the leaf, them in the book, me not understand.
Why, me not understand, I'm going to
book. Alright, so you want me to know. You want me to know, because, you talk to the manager?
When the manager, when we go up, them in the city manager, me talk to one of the young lady, one of the clerk, and she say, me have to go get a new book.
No, wait there, that means that you have money in the end, if you want to
take me have to get a new book. So me give me some documents, sir. So me said, oh, me can.
No, hold on. Let me create something clear, so now. Them tell you say you don't have no money in the account.
In the account, but them.
And then them tell you say no, you have to get a new book.
A new book.
Where you get the new book for though?
That's what I ask, sir. So she said, you have to get a new book now.
Yeah, so where you get the new book for? That me where you ask, what you say?
Sir, brother, about time.
What you say?
Sir, bank. Me say, look.
What you say to you?
After 3 years, I come back to the bank. What now get a new book for?
No, yeah. So what you say to you?
She said, me have to get a new book.
No, me hear you say that already. And when you tell her, say, where you get a new book for? When you have the when you finish, what you say to you?
Yeah. With the brother, about time, you just come, you just walk out and say, boy, if this is the way the bank treat me, can't believe after 12 years.
So you have to make it go on?
Eh?
So you have to make it go on?
Why, brother Muta? I independent money me get to know. I'm not ashamed to tell a man that.
No, you don't know. If a bank do me that, you know, I got to sit down in front of the bank for the rest of my life, you know.
Muta.
I can't make them, you know.
Muta. It's the truth, because last time I go me here for me. Me here
for
me. I'm here for me.
They would have taken you with it.
They talk about enough separation, we go to you.
No, so you have gone so far then, that you try to make that
one. When I get on the boat, then I go to the bank boat, and I know the president is safe at the bank boat, and I go to the matter, and I left my boat. What is the boat? You can't go fight the bank boat.
No, you mean you can't fight the bank?
You can't fight the bank. Oh, boat, I'm
you have the book. And the book have when you lodge the money in there.
Last lodgement of everything, brother.
Yeah, alright. So you go to the bank now and them tell you say, you don't have no money in the bank.
You don't have no money in the bank.
And now you go to the manager? No. You
come back out of the bank, brother Buta.
So you know, but you say, so where you call
but
for there? Where you call for?
Me go online and them say, I must go up there tomorrow. But me say, I push around, brother Buta.
Alright, so how long ago this a go on now? How long ago it a go on?
Since 2 weeks, brother Buta.
And 2 weeks, alright, so you never want back the money until now, after 12 years?
No, brother Buta, you know, so I sit down, Mr. Dung, brother Buta, and I see the lady come up in front and I say, Mike, call me Mike, and I say, Mike, what's happened to the money that I gave you? Are you independent?
Oh, you're my son. Eh? Oh, you change your voice so like a foreigner, so that's like, why do you give the money?
Yes, brother Buta, can I help her? She couldn't walk, brother Buta.
Yeah.
See?
Yeah.
I'm going to pass a walk and Yeah. She go there and come back with a booter. And she said, well, no, can't do for me. Say, boy, anything you can do for me, say, brother Mike, I'm going to give you a bike, a car. I'm going to get a car from the brother booter. Independent.
Oh, I know why you take it so, because you never work hard feet. No, that's why you take it so light.
Brother Buta,
Yeah, but somebody can have so much money at the bank and not say, no, come on, wait, it will make it go on.
Brother Buta, she won water out of her mouth.
No, I'm not talking about the woman, you know. I'm not talking about you, you know.
Brother Buta.
So you're not going to bother with it then?
Yeah, I'm not going to go tomorrow, Brother Buta.
So when you go to tomorrow, where you going to do? Yeah, who you going to tomorrow?
I have to go to the bank manager, because the bank manager was the one that was there.
The bank manager tell you, say you don't have the money at the bank, or the clerk, the bank clerk.
The clerk, Brother Buta.
Well, you need to go sit down with the manager, and you say you go up there.
Brother
Buta. All right, here we go, though. Enter, you go to the manager, call me back and tell me what happened next week.
All right, Brother Buta.
All right?
Yes, Brother
Buta. And say, IT lady for me.
All right, Brother Buta.
Yeah, all right, give thanks.
Yes, Brother
Buta. Yes. Here we go, musically.
Hey, Buta Baruka.
All right, hello, man.
My brother, no. You know, some men say give thanks and a whole lot of praise for the work we are going on. Can't thank you enough.
Yeah, give thanks. Yeah.
Them two programs here save a whole lot of people.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah, man. And then we take a listen to a couple program Sunday for the first in the army. I tell you, say, it's a joy, though.
All right,
we
have
to keep them in our schedule. But the main thing, I call you last week, me on the program, you talk about the African talent on the French team. So, a little comedian brother, Trevor Noah, he did make a joke on South Africa when the World Cup on there.
Yeah, maybe, come on.
Yeah, but what's happening now, you know, for the French ambassador?
Yeah, call him.
Write him a letter.
Yeah, yeah,
so, make sure,
man.
Them things are deeper than just sports, you know?
What do you mean, man?
When things are deeper than just sports, when we're just chopper sleep out of both sports, we just have to go on like that, you know?
Yeah.
But that's the motor, is that you like to listen to the man here, sir.
You thanks, man.
And I like to work with the man I go out with, and go on and deal with them out of these things from Dave themselves, because I'm here, so I can't get to know about
it. Yeah, tell you, it's flew up again, man.
Yeah, here it's
flew up again.
The work is done.
Yeah.
I guess I'm going to have a good time. I don't know what to say, but I don't, yeah, but we have to try and find a way to reach out to the youth them still. Because youth
I can't keep to hurt people,
you know?
Yeah.
I don't keep to hurt people, but I just want one thing to move on. Just go and get yourself on the work and fireball. We will have a bridge to the motor east there. It's gonna.
All right, sir. Yeah, man.
Sorry, Mozart, continue the job here, sir.
Yeah, blessed man, yes. You know, as long as the gun them about there, you know, it will have a quiet little more, you know. It's a quiet little, you know. But if I the gun them there and something happened, the gun will come out back. So it's like you're peace in our community little more. And that's not no part of the sound, you know. It goes quiet, and if something happened, you hear the gun them come out back. So if you don't get the gun them, it's going to go on, because the gun them, you know. You them have gone, and then you say in the area, them just mask that, and then when you gone, them just come up back with that. You don't have to gone either. You don't have to gone either, you know. From a guy, touch a guy and trouble a guy, and all them, then a guy come out and just start the madness again, I tell you, anyway. Yes, yeah.
Yes?
Yes.
Yes, Walter.
Yeah.
So I tell you, I'm going to big up on everything, you know?
All right, so give thanks.
Yeah, yeah. One day that issue with the body that they make out the addition, I really appreciate the sugar drink which has been coming to America as the oil is there. And it's, I wanted to compare that with the Phenomix program. Have you ever heard that?
The what?
Phenomix. It's a American biotechnology company in America.
Yeah.
Which, the fetuses of aborted babies to put in certain drink products.
You read it on the internet.
So I want to know if that is true.
But I can't tell you if it's true, because I don't believe you, but I can't tell you if it's true.
Yeah.
And everything I read on WhatsApp or internet, I believe, you know.
Yeah. Because it's not
expensive that is very true.
Yeah, we really need to see, but we just delete that, you know.
Yeah, right.
Until we can get some more evidence about that. Because somebody look like a real news and a fake news, too.
Yeah, yeah, could be.
Yeah, yeah.
Because we don't choose too much sugar for that, because if you read a little bit on the typical drink, you know, it's more than one serving. Most of the time, it's at least 2 serving to 3.
Well, sugar is a joke, you know.
Yeah, and most people drink one complete drink, you know, for the day.
Yeah, man.
One is at 3, so you can't imagine the amount of sugar.
May I tell you? Most people are using sugar as a drug. It's a legal drug all over the place. So people are going like, say, you know, it's like ganja. Ganja, ganja kill your body. And the amount of people sugar kill and have diabetes and them, so it's a joke.
Yes. Well, I think it's a pretty move that the government of Jamaica is taking a step to ban most of those products, you know?
Yeah, yeah.
So I would just like them to continue investigating more products which are coming
down the country. Yes, sugar, yeah, man. And thought carbide, you know, because I remember carbide should turn to sugar in a year, you know.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Well, you have too much carbide, too much white flour, white sugar, white rice, white bread, all sorts of white things we are consuming away.
Yeah, yeah.
All right, Reggie, give thanks.
Yes, yeah, we're here, yeah.
Yeah, yeah, we need to get you that some holy by them liquor. White things we are about the place, yeah. Yes. We have said that without apology. Because you know, pan the food them where we have a color in it. It's the most destructive food them. Yeah, the most destructive. I don't mean to say it. I don't mean to make it. And nature. And nature do it. White rice. We are not need to make white rice till a man do that. Make the rice white. White flour. Them no bother eat winged flour. Them want to eat. When them take out all the things in it and left it going in there. The still starch left. That's why people use them paste kite. When you have picnic and dance posters, you want now go just get some flour and mix it up. And go paste by the wall. It stay there till rain come down, it sun come dry it. White rice, white sugar, white flour, white bread. All them things, man. If you have no water to flush your toilet, and you don't want to go to the tile because you can't flush it, just name all of them fool them. You never go to the tile until you get back water, especially in the Georgia. Make it. Yes, we are going forward now, I believe you. We're up here, youth, yeah. And then we're up here, young youth. We're say young youth. Yeah, so old youth, they're more inflated, we're like a big youth. Big youth, a old youth, you know, anyway. We have to play this youth, John, and we have to play our old man, John. And share that level, listen to this. We want to play a tune from Virgin, we're in a James Mountain and Johnny Black, you know. And Pinchy. Yeah, we want to play a tune for Pinchy and Johnny Black. And also, we're in a little age group there. We're talking about like 70 and below and beyond. You know what I mean? Not like young, yeah. Young 23-year-old, and I work out to them, Junior. But we have to play this, Junior. Here we go, here we go. Yeah, this is the Stepping Razor. We want to remind you that we are between 5 and 6. It's brought to you by 4. Enjoy the Geekest prepaid mobile data value. Give up yourself today. Why you up, Ivan, you know? You don't want to go be, you know, my friend. Ivan, hear you up. Anyway, assisting right me, put you into the bridge, you know, car about to have money in the bank and you go to back and you get it. Your sister say no. The sister says a fishy story. She either wrote him a check that bounced, which is the woman who gave the money now. She either wrote him a check that bounced, or he withdrew money with just the card. Never updated the book and now trying to play the phone with the woman. Like the bank stole $35,000 from him. Anyway. Which Jamaican have money in the bank for 12 years and never once try to spend any of it? Please. That is Mrs. Chin argument. Which Jamaican have $25,000 in the bank for 12 years? Maybe we'll go away. We don't know. Maybe we'll go away. Yeah. We don't know. Anyway, that is the same. Go back to the bank. So that is just somebody who has listened. I realize the boy, this guy's so fishy. So you're right, you know, give thanks to the moment, give thanks to young, young. Yes, we have to really give thanks to young, young, more than one, two, three, four, five, six times. Yes. But I hear of Shamara, somewhere in Jamaica, I don't know, maybe upstairs. Why you know the black princess, Princess Black outside, the operator. Why you know me on gray. Vita especially. Welcome, hey Vita! Is it a ginger thing there? Trust me. If you have it long enough, now I come back down there again in life. Believe you me. And two other go and drive, we go and turn it on. Trust me, man. Say you also know. I see next time, so you're going to play the last tune and come out of here, so.